Welcome to the last section on nutrition tools, and in this section we're covering phytonutrients. Phytonutrients can also be called phytochemicals, and I will be using the term interchangeably. Phytonutrients are biologically active substances in plants, and they're associated with a decreased risk of chronic disease, helping to prevent cancer and heart disease. Those are examples of chronic diseases. Now, there are thousands of chemicals, phytochemicals, in plants. Thousands and thousands, but we only know a lot about a few of them. We don't truly understand how phytochemicals interact with each other in the body. We don't know how they interact or fully understand all of their actions in our body. At this point, it's just an exciting area of research, and there's definitely more to be learned. Now, plants develop their phytochemicals, and I'll take this carrot for example. This purple color represents one of the phytonutrients in the carrot. They develop these phytochemicals to protect themselves. An example would be leaves on a shrub or a bush or a tree. Those closer or more exposed to the sun are going to develop more phytonutrients, phytochemicals, to protect those leaves from the sun. Because although they need the sun, they need to protect themselves from the UV radiation. So when we consume the plants, then we will obtain those protective agents, those protective biologically active agents called phytochemicals. Now, if we take a look at some of the colors that can occur in carrots, most of us are thinking about a carrot that looks like this, but all of these colors represent phytonutrients. Now, phytonutrients help protect us because they act as antioxidants. That's one of their functions and the one we'll be talking about. Free radicals, which we're exposed to daily, they're a result of metabolic reactions in our body. We are exposed to free radicals in our environment and from the food that we eat. Phytochemicals help to neutralize those free radicals. When free radicals are allowed to just roam through the body without being neutralized, they're very unstable and they want to bind to our tissues, our cell membranes, our DNA, which would then cause damage and lead to chronic diseases such as cancer or heart disease. But these phytonutrients in the plants that we consume can help quench those free radicals. They can neutralize those free radicals so they won't cause the damage in the first place. So that's why we want to eat, to consume a lot of plant food with phytochemicals. Now, I'm saying that we look at a lot of colors. This is kale. You can see different colors in the stems. Each of those colors is representing some phytochemicals. But you don't have to, even though I encourage you to eat from a spectrum of colors, some plant food without color also has phytochemicals, such as garlic. Now I'll talk a little bit about garlic and how processing can impact the phytonutrient content. And it varies from plant class to plant class. In general, whenever you boil a vegetable, especially once it's cut, you're going to lose those phytonutrients. All your water-soluble vitamins and your minerals are going to leach out into the water. So if you throw that water away, you're going to be throwing away those nutrients. That's why steaming is generally a preferred method. Some nutrients are can be destroyed when they're exposed to heat or high heat. And with garlic, the allicin, which is the phytonutrient you want, is actually very heat stable. But you need alanase, the enzyme, to convert it to allicin, and that only happens once the garlic is crushed. The enzyme is very unstable with heat, so if you just stick your garlic into the oven, if you put it in the crock pot, you put it in your stir fry, and the garlic isn't crushed, you're going to destroy the enzyme that is necessary to convert to the allicin, which is the phytonutrient that we want. So the preparation for garlic is to crush it, not chop it, but crush it, let it sit for 10 minutes, and then you can add it to any dish you want and cook it however you want. Tomatoes are another example, and they have lycopene. This dark red color with that gives this pigment to the tomato is from lycopene. Now, there's actually more lycopene in cooked tomatoes than in raw tomatoes, which seems a little bit strange. There's a process that is actually increasing our antioxidant activity. It's decreasing vitamin C because vitamin C is not heat stable, but it's boosting the antioxidant activity because it boosts the lycopene. So actually, a tomato paste or canned tomatoes actually has more lycopene than a raw tomato. So when you are doing your discussion this week, those are some of the preparation methods that I want you to think about and to research and to write about in the discussion. This is the end of our phytonutrient section and the end of our chapter discussion.